More than a decade ago, tribal educators and elders created a framework to teach all South Dakota students about Native history, culture, and traditions. The Oceti Sakowin Essential Understandings and Standards would offer information about the Lakota, Dakota, and Nakota people of the region. The South Dakota Board of Education Standards officially adopted the material in 2011, but state law does not explicitly require that teachers use it in class. A recent Department of Education survey shows that 45% of responding teachers employ the standards in their classes. The most recent attempt to require the standards died in committee a few weeks ago, with an 8-7 vote. Representative Puri Poirier, a Democrat from Pine Ridge, was the prime sponsor.
This is important because South Dakota does have 9 tribal nations within the state of South Dakota. They are nations. They're not just a race. This bill is not about race. This bill is that we have nations within South Dakota who have a political status. They have political boundaries. I believe wholeheartedly that if we were able to have the mechanisms in place to enable teachers to feel comfortable and to carry out these standards, which are called the Oceti Sakowin Essential Understandings, then we can get to a better place of understanding.
Parents and educators spoke in favor of the requirement. Rob Munson with the School Administrators of South Dakota spoke against the move.
Districts as well as educators have the ability to bring the OSE understandings into any curriculum area that they see they fit. We don't need this piece of legislation to confirm that we can already do this.
The House Education Committee agreed, but for some, possible isn't enough. So this year, there's a different proposal before the Senate Education Committee.
If it was working, or if it had come to fruition like school districts said that they could do, you wouldn't be seeing me sitting in this chair today.
Democratic Senator Troy Heinert is from Mission. His bill would create community-based schools that include the Oceti Sakowin Essential Understandings curriculum with other standard academic materials. A nonprofit organization would apply for sponsorship to run the community school with local school district approval. The district and the school's governing board would operate under a 5-year contract, much like a charter school. The sponsoring school district would allocate money to the community school based on the number of students enrolled. Heinert has presented similar proposals before. In 2020, the Senate unanimously supported the bill, which lost steam in a House committee. A follow-up last year failed to reach the House at all. Rapid City Area Superintendent Lori Simon was one of the opponents. She worried about the lost funding for public schools. Simon said the district could develop a magnet school instead.
I really believe that it, through really good collaboration, could achieve the same goals the sponsors of Senate Bill 68 were hoping to achieve without all of the logistical and financial and governance issues that we've discussed.
Since then, the Rapid City Area School District has formed an Indigenous Education Task Force to consider the options, and there is now a Lakota Language Immersion Program at Canyon Lake Elementary. Those accomplishments are touted by those who are opposed to Heinert's proposal for community-based schools.
Have they done it fast enough? But they're in the process of it. We also have immersion schools. So we're making progress. I don't want people to think we've been dragging our feet, because we're not.
But governance and funding concerns fuel the primary opposition. Wade Pogany of the Associated School Boards of South Dakota says this bill creates private schools that receive public funds.
It says the application must be approved if. This is not discretionary for school boards. If the good folks here were to put a proposal together and put it in front of the Sioux Falls School Board, or the Aberdeen School Board, or the Rapid City School Board, it's a forced marriage. Section 25 says, essentially, that the sponsoring school district, remember the forced marriage that we have, the sponsoring school district will portion the total funding received by the district in accordance to this chapter. Total funding received. Folks, they would take a proportionate share of the students in the school, and then they would be forced to give the money of that proportionate share of all their funds.
Senator Heinert was blunt in his rebuttal.
Those kids are still enrolled in that district. They just happen to go to a different attendance center.
Committee members pressed for more clarity in the bill to appease opponents. Senator Wayne Steinhauer, a Republican from Hartford, told Heinert the state needs to try something different to address the academic achievement gap for Native students. He supported the bill in the past, but suggested some changes, including details on the contract and funding.
And then I could get really excited about it. I'll vote for this to move to the floor, but I might not vote for it on the floor because I think there should have been progress made on that. And I understand that when we put in an operating agreement, that it is shifting some of the control back to the school board, but there's got to be some give and take here. And would you please respond to that thought?
We could improve this this bill with an addition like you've suggested. So I will take that to the coalition and we'll get that amendment drafted.
The bill passed through committee with a 6-1 vote, and Heinert brought the amendment to the Senate floor. It avoids forcing districts to accept applications. It includes the operating agreement in the application process and reduces the maximum number of community-based schools from 4 to 2.
It really is a significant change, and I think it's going to create partnership, which is really what we want this bill to do.
Senator Heinert hits his term limit this year, so this is his last legislative session. He spelled out the need in his closing remarks.
Graduation rate, 90% for non-Native students. Congratulations. For Native students, 54. Now, it has been that way in my community for 60 years. I'm tired. I don't want it to be that way anymore. Our kids deserve it. My community deserves it. My community deserves a chance to change. And we shouldn't have to change who we are as Lakota people. That's what this is asking for. Two schools. Two.
The Senate passed the amended bill with a 22-13 vote. It moves next to the House Education Committee, the same group that voted it down 2 years ago.